Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of our boot camp series for combat from Compass Games and Ross Mortel. I am Cliff, aka Wee Beasties, and in today's episode, I want to cover Duckback. Duckback is an important action in the combat system. It really informs the way the AI plays, and I call this an action and not an order. Because technically, all the things that are called orders in this game system are actually actions. We give orders to soldiers, and then they execute them because they're very obedient little soldiers, and they carry out the actions we've committed them to for that turn. Duck back is not an order that you can give to a soldier during the order phase. Instead, it's an action that occurs during play. I think of duck back as the oh crap during the play of the game. And a soldier, whether friendly or whether enemy, is carrying out some action and something very bad has just happened, or is happening, or may be about to happen, and the soldier basically says, "Oh crap, I don't want to be doing this anymore. I'd rather be hiding." Duck back is that transition between whatever they were doing and getting to the state of hiding, which will occur in the next impulse. There are a lot of different ways that duck back can occur during the play of the game. When I was a boy, Paul Simon sang that there were 50 ways to leave your lover. Well, there are nearly that many ways to duck back in combat. So let's take some time and go through some of the various ways that soldiers can duck back. The first is up and get shot, Scott. At least I'm not going to sing it. I could make it worse. So the first way that a soldier can receive a duck back command action is to get shot at and suffer a wound. Now, I've got some soldiers on the board just to demonstrate, and I'm going to get rid of these little duck back character chits here. So I'm just going to delete those off. Let's say that, you know, the Private Meeks here has fired up at Soldat Beck, and Beck gets a light wound. There he is. Whenever a soldier receives a light wound or a bad wound, they immediately duck back and cease whatever they were doing. So this guy would get a duck back. Let's put it on top so you can see it. He immediately loses whatever order he had and gets a duck back. Same thing is true whenever you get a bad wound. This is true for both sides. So part of the wound process is you immediately lose your order and you duck back, and then they're going to have to take a wound morale check as well. But that's a separate thing. So that's the first way, and a very common way, to get duck back. And let's get rid of that. Control D. There we go. The second way to get duck back is make a new plan, Stan. As soldiers are carrying out their orders, they can decide to change what they're doing. Let's say that, you know, Walsh down here had a sprint order. And he decides that, okay, in my first move, I'm going to go here, and oh, look, there's all these Germans out here. I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to continue to sprint. Well, you've committed to sprint for the entire turn. The only thing you can do other than follow through on the sprint command and run two and two and two is to just bail and say, you know what, I'm going to get rid of that sprint command and I'm going to duck back instead. Duck back is going to give you extra cover, and in the next turn, he's going to hide. In the next impulse, that will turn to a hide, like that. Let's see here. When we're shooting, that would be this one here's our weapon skill. So if he was sprinting in the trees, sprinting in the trees is a minus two. When he ducks back, he goes to a minus two, not much better. He's in the process of hiding, but then he's going to hide in the next impulse where he'll be minus four. So during the oh crap moment, he doesn't really get much extra cover, but in the next impulse, he will get more cover in those trees because he's going to be hiding as best he can. So I could take that off. All right, third way. Well, not even that. We got to talk about enemy soldiers because the enemy soldiers are slightly different here. We can always opt as the friendly unit to duck back at the end of our impulse. Remember, there are three things we do when we go through our sequence of play. As we activate each soldier, they're going to execute their order. They're going to attempt any spotting attempts that are necessary, and then they have the option to duck back. That's for friendly. For an enemy, let's say this guy has let's give him like a sneak. And let's say it's a sneak six. There, it's got a sneak six. In his first impulse, he does nothing. Second impulse, let's say it's second impulse, he sneaks into the hedge. He's now entered into cover. He has the option or the ability to possibly duck back here, but in order to do that, he has to pass a unmodified TQ check, troop quality check, and this guy Beck has a troop quality of 7, so he's going to have to roll a d10, a decimal die. So let's see, that's here. He rolls an 8, he fails, so he would not get to duck back. But if he passed 3, he would duck back. So he does an unmodified TQ, and if he passes, he will eliminate this order and become a duck back. And then in the following impulse, he would hide. So we can just do it. They have to actually pass a TQ if they enter cover and have LOS to a known enemy unit, which he does here in the case of Walsh. All right, so that's make a new plan, Stan. Now go win your melee, Ray. So if units are in melee, we're sharing a hex. They're together and they're in melee. If a unit wins melee, so let's see here, and let's say Lang is eliminated, and he's KIA'd out of there, and now Walsh is by himself and has no other enemy units with him, this melee will become a duck back, and I would just duck him back. If there is still another unit in there with him, he would not be able to duck back. You don't get to duck back when you're in melee actively with another opposing soldier present. Even if you get a wound during melee, you don't duck back. You never duck back in melee. You're in there hacking away with your fists and your knife and your bayonet, and it is much too involved to be trying to just duck back, curl up, and hide. You'd be dead. All right, then hop in the rock, Brock, as long as you're sprinting. In the case of a sprinting soldier, if you enter rough terrain, which is rock, but also building, marsh, hedge, bocage, wall, crater, and rumble, and stream in Volume 1, and I believe in Volume 2 that would probably also include the abbey and fountains in that little pond. Any rough terrain, if you enter while sprinting, you immediately lose your sprint command and it's replaced by a duck back. So if Let's take this command off here. Let's say that Walsh was going to sprint. So let's give him a sprint here. There he's sprinting. And in impulse one, he went here. In impulse two, he enters here. Hedge is rough. And these hedgerow maps make sprinting tough because you're often going to hit rough terrain. I mean, fields, not rough. Hedge is rough. As soon as he enters the hedge, he loses that sprint. So let's lose that sprint and give him a duck back. That could be handy. You just sprint up, he duck back, and then the next impulse he hides, and he's going to be spotting to see what's around inside that field that the bocage is delimiting. Now in the case of enemy, it's similar but slightly different because we've got to provide a little intelligence for, let's say that Beck here has a sprint. So let's give him a sprint. Now they got to have directions on theirs. So let's say he has a 6-1. So let's make that a 6-1. So now Beck's got a sprint 6-1. If he sprints 6 in the first impulse, he'll have to duck back. But he's not going to want to duck back if he can avoid it. So he would not duck back. He would not jump into the hedge if he can avoid it. If this was just a sprint 6 and he had no choice, he would jump in there and duck back. But since direction 1, going directly south, would allow him to continue to sprint without ducking back, he will elect to skip impulse 1. And on impulse 2, move in direction 1, 2 hexes. Then, in impulse 3, he would have a 6th direction, which allow him to move 1, but he wouldn't duck back if he can avoid it, so he'd stop. And then, in the last impulse, he has no choice but to go in here and duck back. And then we just duck him back. If he ducks back on impulse 4, it won't become a hide. He just gets a new order next turn. So the enemy soldiers try not to duck back if they can avoid it. We can choose freely because, well, we are the friendly player. Then, just fail an MC, Lee, and set yourself free. Anytime you fail a morale check, for any reason, whether the morale check has been caused by, well, you got a near miss and you had to pass a morale check. If you fail, you're going to duck back. If you have a morale check because a grenade went off in your hex or next to your hex, whether or not you were injured, if you fail that morale check, you duck back. If artillery lands next to you or in your hex, and even if you're not injured, you fail your morale check, you're going to duck back. If the C4 charge is placed on a gun, causes you to take a morale check and you fail, you're going to duck back. All of these duck backs for things like C4, for artillery, and grenades happen at the end of a turn. So the entire turn is done and you're going through the resolution part of the 5th stage of our sequence of play. Therefore, the duck back that you get will apply to the next turn. You begin the turn with a duck back and you'll turn that into a hide. And you're basically going to be hiding the entire turn. All right. That's enough of the dad humor part. We've got ourselves free. There are some other situations where soldiers can encounter a duck back. A charge command, for instance. This works for either. You can only be given a charge if you're 4 or less away. So let's say that Lang is up here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 hexes to Lang from Meeks. And let's give Meeks a charge command. Nah, that's a sprint command, Cliff. Give him a charge. There, it's got a charge command. If everything stays the same, he could charge 1 hex and then another hex. And then in the third impulse, he would enter into the hex with Lang and begin melee. But if he moves a hex in impulse one, and then Lang decides, well, I'm going to just move back here to this hedge. Now, I won't be able to reach him, because in impulse two, I'd be able to go one. Impulse three, two, I'm not going to be able to get there. If your charge command is no longer sufficient to enter melee by the end of the third impulse, then you must get rid of the charge command and give the duck back. So if your target moves away so that you're no longer able to successfully complete the charge command, you have to bail. Loss of a guard is another possibility. So if during play, let's get rid of some of these guys. Let's say that Meeks is taken back as a prisoner and now he's got a guard. So now Beck is the prisoner of Meeks. If Meeks is somehow incapacitated or eliminated so that he's no longer present in that hex, the guard is gone, Beck, without his guard around to guard him, will immediately duck back and then hide, and then will begin to get his orders as usual in the following. All right. Another possibility is route for the Americans. So let's say that this guy is up here, and let's get rid of that duck back. Let's control our field of view. Let's say that we'll put these guys up here, so they're up north. And let's say that Meeks has been pretty beaten up, and he's got a morale state of route. See, he's routing. And we try to rally him, so we give him a rally order. We go through that entire turn of doing nothing, trying to rally him, and he rolls a rally attempt, and he fails. Poor Meeks. So if we lose that rally marker. There, finally. And he's routing. He'll have to route like direction 5. So he routes direction 5 on his turn, but he's entered into terrain that's cover, and he's out of LOS of an enemy soldier. If you have a route and you've moved into cover and you're out of LOS of enemy soldiers, you can attempt to duck back by rolling an unmodified troop quality check. So he'd need a 5 or less, and he would roll a 9, and of course he fails, so he wouldn't. That's how I typically roll, is a lot of 9s when I'm rolling American rolls. I don't know about you. All right, so let's roll again. 3. With a 3, he would pass, and then he would duck back instead of continuing his route. He would hide. The German, with a similar situation, would attempt to rally again, put another rally command there. They don't duck back. So that's a difference. American soldiers can also fire flares when there is illumination to consider. So if we're here, and let's get rid of that duck back. Let's give him an aim fire, which is aim fire. In an aim fire, he can place a flare within 3. Fires a flare. It becomes illuminated. Let's just illuminate that. There. Becomes illuminated. And this guy who fired it will now get rid of his command and become a duck back. Only the Americans, so far, fire flares. So I don't have to show that. And I can get rid of that, because I'm done with the flare now, and I get rid of that duck back. All right. Neutral edge considerations. Let's say this top edge is a neutral edge. This is for the Germans. Obviously, the Americans can avoid a neutral edge. We don't have to move off of it. But let's say we've got Beck here on the road, and he's got an order to evade. Let's give him a nice evade order. Okay. Let's say he has an evade 4. So we'll pop him down to 4. An evade 4 would say go directly north. We'll evade 1, we go up here. And then the next one would push him off the neutral edge. At that point, he would say, nope, not going to go off the neutral edge. We get rid of that guy and we apply a duck back. But let's say that he's here. And let's take that duck back off. Let's give him a different evade order. So here he's got an evade. Let's say that he has an evade. Oh, let's put him over here. Let's make it, no, let's do it here. Stick with your story, Cliff. Let's make it an evade 4-5. An evade 4-5. In impulse 1, he wants to move north, but that would move him off the neutral edge. So he doesn't want to do that. So he will skip his impulse, because in impulse 2, he can move in direction 5 and be okay. So he skips 1 and doesn't move 4. In impulse 2, he moves 5, and now he's here. Impulse 3, he wants to move 4 again. He doesn't want to do that. Impulse 5 would also force him to move off. At that point, he doesn't have any options. Either one of these options is going to move him off. So he's going to just ditch that command and duck back at that point. So they won't move off a neutral edge if they have a choice. They will move off friendly edges to gain points, or they will move off their enemy edge to lose points, but they will not move off a neutral edge voluntarily. If they're going to be forced to, they duck back instead. Last situation to talk about is ammo state. If Charlie fires like I usually fire, he's going to end up with a 9 and run out of ammo. Then, if he rolls another 9 with that low ammo, he's going to flip it over to out of ammo. Walsh here is one of my soldiers. When you're out of ammo, you just can't fire your primary weapon. You do not duck back. You're forced to reload. That is not true of how the enemy behaves. If the enemy is here and Lang is shooting back and he runs low on ammo by rolling a 9, which the Germans hardly ever do when I'm rolling, and he manages to roll another 9, a little karma for the Germans there, he will flip that over to out of ammo. Now, Lang here only has his KAR and a grenade. He has no other weapons. When he's out of ammo, he will duck back. We don't duck back, but the enemy ducks back, and he'll get a duck back order. Let's give him 1. There. Let's put that on top. There. Now he ducks back. And then he'll hide because he's out of ammo. In the future, if he gets a fire order, then he'll get a reload instead. And he'll try to reload. Those are the basic ways that we can duck back. This is an important concept and really affects the way that the AI plays A lot of times people don't do duck back quite right on the playthroughs you'll see online. I mean, they've got a lot of things to keep track of. They're trying to do a video, they're doing editing, they're trying to remember the rules, they're trying to think about what they're doing. It's understandable. But here, I try to lay it out cleanly, as best I can, the legal ways and the correct ways that you should duck back. Sure, there aren't quite 50 ways to duck back soldiers, but hey, there were only 5 ways to leave your lover, so I don't feel too bad. I'll see you guys next time. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Or hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much.